everyone. This is David Watson from Plain Truth, a Holy Spirited podcast. And I'm here today with another of our Plain Truth shorts, this time on John Wesley and the gifts of the Spirit. John Wesley lived during the period of the European Enlightenment. In some ways, he was a product of the Enlightenment, though he was wary of the direction in which certain Enlightenment thinkers were heading. One area of concern for Wesley was the diminishment of belief in miracles that was fueled by the rising philosophical currents of his day. Wesley believed that God provided the church with all the gifts of the Spirit listed in 1 Corinthians 12 and Romans 12. These gifts, he believed, were not just for the early church, but for sincere Christians throughout the ages. For Wesley, not all workings of the Holy Spirit were expressed through events we would call miraculous. He distinguished between ordinary and extraordinary gifts of the Spirit. Among the extraordinary gifts, he includes many of those listed in 1 Corinthians 12, 8-11, such as, and I quote, healing the sick, prophesying in the proper sense of the word, that is, foretelling things to come, speaking with strange tongues, such as the speaker had never learned, and the miraculous interpretation of tongues. Among the ordinary gifts he includes, and I quote again, the gift of convincing speech in order to sound the unbelieving heart, and the gift of persuasion to move the affections, as well as enlighten the understanding. We may covet knowledge, both of the word and of the works of God. We may desire a measure of faith, which goes far beyond the power of natural causes. We may desire an easy elocution, a pleasing address, with resignation to the will of our Lord. Yea, whatever would enable us, as we have opportunity, to be useful wherever we are. While Wesley was no cessationist, he believed that the gifts of the Spirit were far less common in the church after the first three centuries. In his sermon, The More Excellent Way, he explains why. I quote again, it does not appear that these extraordinary gifts of the Holy Ghost were common in the church for more than two or three centuries. We seldom hear of them after that fatal period when the Emperor Constantine called himself a Christian, and from a vain imagination of promoting the Christian cause, thereby heaped riches and power and honor upon the Christians in general, but in particular upon the Christian clergy. From this time, they almost totally ceased. Very few instances of the kind were found. The cause of this was not, as has been vulgarly supposed, because there was no more occasion for them, because all the world was become Christian. This is a miserable mistake. Not a 20th part of it was then nominally Christian. The real reason was the love of many, almost of all Christians so-called, was waxed cold. The Christians had no more of the Spirit of Christ than the other heathens. The Son of Man, when he came to examine his church, could hardly find faith upon the earth. This was the real cause why the extraordinary gifts of the Holy Ghost were no longer to be found in the Christian church, because the Christians were turned heathens again and had only a dead form left. In short, Wesley believed that the diminishment of the gifts comes from the complacency of the church, a lack of faith, fervor, and love. It would follow that, were we to move beyond our own complacency into a position of greater faith, fervor, and love, we would see more of the kinds of miracles described in the New Testament. One last point. For Wesley, like Paul, love was greater than all the other gifts. So while we should earnestly seek all the gifts of the Spirit, above all else, we should seek to become more perfect in love. In other words, we should seek the sanctifying grace of God so that we might become more Christ-like people. The other gifts are important, but without love, we are simply noisy gongs and clanging cymbals. Thanks for listening today. We hope you like the podcast. If you do, the best way to support us is by leaving a 5-star review on your favorite podcast provider. You can also subscribe to the podcast, like our page on Facebook, and follow at Holy Spirit Pod on Twitter. Have a blessed week, and we will be back with more podcast episodes soon.